to vote for. To vote for are doing very little for God. And the thing about it, they don't want you to do something for God. Do your favor, say neighbor. Do something.
Do something.
I want you to understand that everybody in the boat is not going to step out and walk with you on the water. Everybody is not walking by faith. Some people are happy walking by sight. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I don't mean no harm, but y'all give me just, I'm trying to get on my way. Can you imagine hearing Doubting Thomas in the background telling Peter, man, you better stay in this boat? That you're not going to drown?
Jesus.
Yet by faith, Peter steps out of the boat and he successfully walks on the water. As the narrative continues, as the narrative continues, we can see the sinking in the walk.
Uh-huh.
Yes. When Peter shifted his attention from Jesus back to the circumstance, then we see the saving in the walk. That's, oh, thank you, Lord. That's when, thank you, Lord, Peter cried out to Jesus and said, Lord, save me. And then we can see the scolding after the walk. That's a little while. That's when Jesus stretched forth his hand and caught him and said, oh, thou of little faith, why didn't I doubt? Well, y'all rest for a little while. I come to the Lord is good. See, I'm trying to understand that after, thank you, Lord, the saving that Jesus saved Peter from drowning, the Lord rebuked him. Jesus said, oh, thou of little faith, why didst thou doubt? Oh, y'all rest for a little while. See, thank you, Lord, Peter's faith was affected by doubt. But at least he had enough of faith to walk that far. But see, Peter, thank you, Lord, what Peter needed was to stay focused and continue walking in faith to complete his walk. Thank you, Lord. But this is what arises, the question that arises is, thank you, Lord, why Jesus didn't commend Peter for his efforts? Why he didn't say, Peter, I'm so proud of you. At least you did what the other disciples wouldn't do. For you stepped out on faith. But the rest of them allowed doubt to keep them in the boat. You reach down and you save him, but you scold him. You didn't say thank you for trying, at least try to come to me. See, you got to understand, thank you, Lord, and keep this in our mind. We have to understand, thank you, Lord, that faith is an individual thing in the sight of God. And every one of us has to answer for ourselves, despite what anybody else does. See, church, I don't mean no harm, but being that Peter had been walking with Jesus for a long time. Thank you, Lord. He had seen many miracles that the Lord had done. Peter had seen Jesus, thank you, Lord, fill his own boat with a multitude of fish. Peter had seen Jesus, thank you, Lord, heal his own mother-in-law. Thank you, Lord. Peter had seen Jesus turn water into wine doing happy hour. Not only that, you gotta understand that Peter had just seen Jesus, thank Lord, take two small fish and five barley loaves of bread and feed 5,000 as well as women and children. And after all these miracles that Peter has seen, there was no reason. There was no reason, thank the Lord, to doubt. If we would be completely honest with ourselves, many of us have been with the Lord for a long time now. Many of us have seen Him work. Many of us have seen the Lord make ways out of nowhere. We have seen the Lord open doors that were closed in our face. We have seen miracles, thank you, Lord, of salvation and miracles of healing. Thank you, Lord. That we should start doubting God. See, the hymn said, we've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord, trusting in His holy word. Oh, he has to get personal, because you understand that sometimes, even though it was corporate, you got to look at faith by myself. I got to go by myself. So the writer said, He's never failed me.
He has never.
And even though that the enemy is putting things before me, he has decided, oh, can't turn around.